Now to the Middle East and the latest on the Israel-Hamas war. Doctors say they're cautiously optimistic about the survival of 28 premature babies rushed from Gaza to Egypt. In the meantime, sources tell ABC News an agreement to free as many as 50 civilian hostages from Hamas custody could be near. Justin Finch has the latest from Washington.
Greeting crowds at the White House, President Biden responding to a reporter asking if a deal is coming soon to free some of the 236 hostages remaining in Hamas custody.
Mr. President, is a hostage deal near?
The U.S. teaming up with Israel and Qatar in hostage talks with Hamas. Sources tell ABC News negotiators are making headway on a deal calling for Hamas to release 50 hostages in exchange for Israel allowing more aid into Gaza and a five-day ceasefire. But no common ground reached yet on the exact number of hostages and how long that ceasefire would last. Families of civilian hostages holding out hope.
This is important to understand that these people, they are citizens.
In Egypt, the World Health Organization says doctors are treating 28 premature babies from Gaza.
They're not out of the woods yet by any means.
The Hamas-run Palestinian Health Ministry says at least 9 babies have already died, while the UN estimates at least 5 have died. All are from Gaza's Al-Shifa Hospital, where their incubators lost power more than a week ago. And where Israel says Hamas militants ran a command post and hid hostages, which Hamas denies. The Israel Defense Force is releasing video justifying their ground action inside Al-Shifa. Israel's military says this drone video shows a Hamas tunnel 30 feet below the hospital leading to a steel blast door. Israeli forces and Hamas also facing off outside North Gaza's Indonesian hospital. Israel says no shells were fired at the complex, but the Hamas-run Palestinian Health Ministry says a shell strike killed at least a dozen people at that hospital. Justin Finch, ABC News, Washington.